My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda with AV Ultra, and today we're going to be getting started with After Effects. What this course is designed to do is teach you the basics of everyday production using After Effects. So what can you do with After Effects? After Effects is a post-production motion graphics tool that you can use to create pretty much anything that you can imagine as long as you've got that imagination. Some examples that I have here are some tracking that I've done here. So this is some screen replacements I've done. So you can see what we have here is we have the screen and then we end up replacing it. So this is very common things that I do in After Effects. Another thing that's very common in After Effects is adding graphics already to video. So this is a little thing I did for Verlo mattresses a little bit ago. And you can see I've put together a bunch of these different graphics. And so I animated all these different pieces as a motion graphics piece. Another example I've got here is some more motion graphics for a different event here that was in town. And so you can see all this is kind of put together using motion graphics. And another sign replacement here. So this is a little bit more VFX post-production. You can see the original sign and what's been replaced with it. We can also be using it to create some different kinds of animation and graphics. So in this case, I was using Element 3D, which is one of the tools that I use and I really recommend with After Effects, should you want to do some 3D work. In the example that we're going to be creating today is just the layout of this with moving video in the background. I've included all these assets with the exercise that you can download, but today we're just going to be getting started with it and learning about layers, shapes, backgrounds, and importing some video. Let's go ahead and get started. We're going to go ahead and take a look at the completed version first so we can understand what's happening in here before we recreate it. Starting with this leftmost panel here, we have our project panel. And in our project panel, we have all of our assets that we have available to us in our project. Think of this as a sandbox where we have all the tools like our shovels and our buckets that we're going to use to make our sandcastle out of for it to exist in here or to be able to use it in our composition window. We have to have that available. We have some different icons in here. So you can see I've got this icon, which is our composition. I've got this, which is just an image file. I have a video file here, and then I have a folder with something in here called a solid. That's all I want to talk about in here right now. So let's go ahead and move on to the next section. Our composition window is our end result. Everything that will be on our screen or is animated or for our final output is going to most likely be in our composition window. Notice that my composition window also reflects that same name that we have here, AE Lesson 1. If I double click one of these assets, it will open up into a new window, which is our footage panel. Our footage panel is just a preview of whatever asset that we're looking at. So if I go ahead and close that, it'll take me back into my composition window. The third thing I want to talk about down here is our composition timeline. You'll notice that we have our AE Lesson 1, and inside of that, we have all these different, we're gonna refer to these as layers. You'll notice I have some different colors in here, and I have some of these that have a little T next to it, some of them that have a little star shape, some that just has a color, our image, and our video. We have a few other icons over here, which we'll get to eventually, but let's go ahead and get started. Open up After Effects. It's going to look mostly like this, a blank slate. And the first thing that we want to do is create a new composition. You would think that to create a new composition, we would just go to File, New Composition, but you'll notice that there's not actually a composition in there. We're actually going to want to go to our composition and go to New Composition, which on the Mac is a shortcut of Command N. Once we have that, we have our composition setting. Our composition settings are very similar to if we were in Photoshop or any other program. It's really asking us what size and shape is our video going to be. Luckily for us, we have some presets down here, and for our purposes, we're gonna go to HDTV 1080 2997. If that's not what you want, you can specify your own width and height and our pixel aspect ratio. We're gonna set a duration right here of 10 seconds. So we want 0, 0, 0, 10 seconds, and we'll hit okay. What we're looking at now is an open blank composition. Yours may or may not have this checkerboard pattern back here. If it does, what you're looking at is a blank canvas. So there's actually nothing happening on the screen here. If yours looks like it's black, it's effectively the same thing, but we've hit this button down here, the transparency grid. What this transparency grid does is it lets us know what's visible on the screen. For example, there's times that I want a graphic to only be, let's say, in this section, and I want it to be opaque, but the rest is going to be clear. I need to know that that's clear by having this transparency grid. We're just gonna close that and make sure that it is solid black for right now. Looking at our example here, we have some video back here. We've got some rectangles, this other triangular piece here, some text, and an image file. So let's talk about importing different objects into After Effects. There are a few different ways that we can do that. We can go to File, Import, and you'll notice that we have lots of different ways that we can import things. I can double click in this blank area, or I can go to my Explorer or Finder window and drag them in that way. For our purposes, just double click in this blank window, and we have our import. And I'm gonna go to my exercise, lesson one, and I'm going to import a few different things. I'm gonna import this After Effects CC. We're also going to double click again and bring in our lesson one background. So now that we have these two objects, if I double click them, you'll notice it opens up in the footage panel for that picture. And if I double click my video file, it also opens up in the footage panel, gives us a small timeline to scrub through. This lets me know how long my video clip is. So in this case, it is exactly 30 seconds and one frame. And I can also see that right up in here. Let's go ahead and close that footage window and talk about this project panel again. I'm gonna zoom in here so we can take a look at this. And if I click on this guy once, it gives me some information about this asset. For example, this file is 600 by 600 pixels and its file name is After Effects CC PNG. If I click on my lesson one background, you'll notice that it is 1920 by 1080 or HD. Its duration is 30 seconds in one frame at 2997. It is millions of colors and its codec is H.264. So let's go ahead and we want to bring this into our composition. I have a couple ways I can do that too. I can either drag that here and you can see the bounding box, or Command Z to undo. I can drag that right down here into my timeline. The difference being, if I drag it over here, you can see I can place it arbitrarily wherever I'd like, or I can drag it down here and it places it in the center of my window. Now this is a little large, and I want to zoom this out just a little bit. So I'm going to come down here to my magnification and we're going to zoom this out to about 50%. And the reason for that is because I want to see outside of here. If I scrub through here or hit the space bar, it's playing through my video file. I also want to bring in this After Effects file. So I'm going to drag this guy, and what I'm going to do is place him right here. Now we have two layers in our composition, and only one is playing back, and that's because only one is a video file. You'll notice in my example, I had that triangular piece here. So what we're going to do with that is just create a solid. A solid is a foundational piece of media that you can think of as a big piece of cardboard. It's just kind of like a full screen image of color. We have a couple ways that we can bring those in. We can go to Layer, New, Solid, or hit Command Y. And when I do that, you'll see it says whatever color it is. I'm gonna pick something maybe bright blue for our purposes right now. And I'm gonna make sure it's 1920 by 1080. If it's not, I'm gonna make it comp size. And we're gonna rename this BG for background. And currently all I see is that BG. The reason why all I see is BG is because it is at the top of the layer stack. So if I drag this BG down, you'll notice now I can see my After Effects logo. And if I drag it down once more, I don't see it at all. The reason being is this lesson one is completely covering the same screen that this background is. If I turn off this layer, you can see it's revealed underneath there. So I'm actually gonna drag this right up in here. And what I wanna do is just drag this over to the corner and I wanna rotate this. How can I rotate this? Well, let's take a look at our tools. Currently, we're using our selection tool, which is V, and I want to go to my rotate tool, which is W. The reason for that is the After Effects team actually thought it was hilarious to call it rotate. Click and hold shift, and as I hold shift, it's going to turn it at 45 degree angles. If I let go of shift, it's going to let me change it any way I want, and I'll hit V, and we're just going to line this up pretty arbitrarily. Let's say right here. And if you'll notice now, if I zoom out hitting my Z key and hit Alt, there is my background layer, but only this much is visible because it's only covering this much of our main screen. If I click and drag my Z key here, you'll notice that I can zoom in just a little bit. And at any time, if I want to go back to a specific zoom, I'm going to go to, let's say, fit. And now, no matter how I resize my window, it is always going to fit and let me see how much of a magnification that is. The next thing we're going to take a look at here is our shape layers. And I can make a shape layer using my shape tool here, which is the letter Q. Clicking and holding onto any of our tools here that have a little tab will reveal more behind it. So my rectangle tool is Q, but I also have a rounded rectangle, ellipse, polygon, and star. I'm going to hit rectangle. And what I want to do is just draw a rectangle. It doesn't necessarily matter where. In fact, I'm going to zoom out again just so I can see a little bit better. And I'm going to draw this rectangle. And obviously, this isn't the color I want. It's got some weird things going on here. So let's dig into this. When I've made this layer, you'll notice it created this new icon here. It made a star shape. And what this star shape means is that this is a shape layer. When we made our background, you'll notice it just kept whatever color our solid was. And our icon for our PNG and our video file are for whatever program that typically opens it. So in this case, I have a program called VLC, which opens my video, and I have Preview, which opens up my PNG files. So now that we have our shape, let's adjust a little bit. I'm going to come up to my fill, and I'm going to click the word fill. And when I've clicked my word fill, I have some different options. I can either make it a transparent, a solid, a linear gradient, or a radial gradient. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and stick with that solid color for right now. But let's go to our stroke, click on the word stroke, and turn that off. What that means is now we don't have any lines around it. There's not a stroke around this rectangle. And I want to change this color. So we're going to click on the actual color of the fill, and let's make this black. I'm going to hit OK. And now what I want to do is rotate this one more time. So I'm going to click my rotate tool. And again, make it 45 degrees. I'll hit V to change back to my selection tool. And I'm just going to place this right here. Notice it's not long enough. And hey, that's OK. I'm just going to grab this edge and stretch it all the way across. That looks pretty good. So now that I have this solid black area here, I actually want this to be pretty transparent like our example. So what I'm going to do is twirl down this disclosure triangle here. We'll have a transform option. If I open up my transform option, we have some position, scale, rotation, anchor point, but I'm concerned about opacity. Now, if I twirl this down to, let's say, 30%, we'll zoom that back out. Now we can start seeing how that's looking like our example. In my example, I had a second one across here. So what I could do is take this shape, copy it by hitting Command C and Command V, or drawing a whole new one from scratch. But the easiest way is just select this guy, hit Command D. It's made two of them now. And now that I have this one selected, I'm just going to click, hold Shift, and drag it over to the left. If I hold Shift, it's going to lock it to a plane. Otherwise, I can kind of drag it all over the place. But by holding Shift, I can just move it right there. The last thing that we want to do here is add our text layer and change this color here. So let's go ahead and change this color. I'm going to go to my effects and presets, and this is really where After Effects shines. If you'll look at your effects and presets, you'll notice that you have a lot of them in here. I might have a few more that you don't, and that's okay. But if you open up any of these, you'll notice that you have a whole lot of different effects in here. It may be hard to actually navigate through all these different effects. Luckily, I know exactly what I'm looking for. So I'm going to click on this magnifying glass and just type in ramp. It may be under gradient, but a gradient and a ramp is effectively the same thing. What I want to do is I want to drag this gradient ramp just onto my background. So I can either drag it right onto here, and you'll notice as I'm dragging across here, I have some different areas that are lighting up. If I want to make sure I'm applying it to the right place, I'm just going to drop it onto that layer. And effectively what this has done is created a ramp across here, and that's starting to look pretty good. As soon as I did that, I had my effect controls pop up. In my effect controls, I have all the options for whatever effect I may be working with. In our case here, we have the start of the ramp, the end of the ramp, and the colors. I'm going to change this color right here to a medium gray. And that's looking pretty good. If I want to work with this a little bit more, maybe I want to change where this gradient begins. I'm going to click on this crosshair and just start dragging here. You can see what that's doing. I'm going to do the same thing with this gray crosshair and just pull this over here. So this is effectively letting me choose where that gradient is happening. Excellent. Let's go ahead and add our text into this. So if I want to add text into here, I have a couple different ways to do that. I can either come up here to my toolbar and hit my horizontal type tool, or I can just hit Command T. And when I hit Command T, I have my text tool pop up. You'll also notice that my character window opened up over here as well. If I just click, I can just type wherever. I'm going to undo that. However, if I click and drag, I can select a text box. So now if I write, you'll notice that it is constrained to that box. So be aware of that when you're doing that. For our purposes right now, what I want to do is turn on something here called Safe Frames. So I'm going to choose my grid and guide options and go to my title action safe. And I just want to make sure that my titles don't go beyond this line here. The reason for that is I produce a lot of graphics for television. By law, every TV has something in here called overscan. What that basically means is even though all HDTVs may be 1080p, some of those pixels might be in the bezel. So we have something called overscan. So sometimes the image will actually only be this big or even this big when originally it's this big. That would explain why when you go to a store and you're looking at the wall of TVs, some TVs are zoomed in almost. So by making sure that we are in this title safe area, we're gonna make sure all our text is visible on every HD TV that's in 16:9. If you're looking for more information about this, I definitely recommend checking out Title Safe or Action Safe Frames. We just want to make sure that we're inside this grid. And I'm just going to go ahead and make a box. And now that I have that, I'm just going to go ahead and put in my title. And you'll notice that I'm running out of room. Well, and that's okay because I can take any of this text, highlight it, and work with it here in the character panel. So for example, I took that and I'm just going to stretch it to there and I'm going to take this guy and pull this guy down quite a bit. So now that I have my text in here, let's go ahead and refine it a little bit more. I'm just going to zoom in. And now that I'm zoomed in, I want to be able to move around my canvas. So I can go up to my hand tool and just move across here. Or if I'm in any of my other tools, I can hold on to the space bar and that turns into a temporary hand tool. So now that we're in here, I'm going to double click. Let's fix my spelling mistakes. And I'm going to start working with this text. I'm going to work with that lighting. I'm going to highlight just this section. And I want them all to reach that same edge. I'm just going to work with that tracking a little bit. And I want this to be quite a bit larger. So we're going to expand that and scoot that down just a little bit. And we're going to go ahead and make this a bit larger. Something like that. The last thing I want to do is I want to give a nice little beveled edge across this area here. If I zoom this out, what we want to do is just add a nice little bevel edge. So we're just going to go to our effects and presets, and I'm going to type in light sweep. Right there, we have an effect called light sweep. And I want to make sure I drop that onto my BG panel. And you'll notice now I have two effects in here. I have my gradient ramp and my light sweep. My light sweep creates this kind of a look. That's what we've got here. But I don't want it across the whole piece. I can work with this a little bit, and instead of the sweep intensity, we're gonna turn that down to zero. We're gonna take our width and really bump that up. Now it's a little hard to see what's going on. It'd be great if we can just see this panel as opposed to the rest of those. Well, we can do that by hitting the solo switch. So our solo switch is right down here. And what this solo switch does is it basically mutes all the rest of those layers. So you can see when I hit that, all the rest of these eyes darken a little bit. And what that looks like is like this. And so in here, if I zoom in, we can really see that nice beveled edge in there. And if I crank up that width up and down, you can kind of see that a little bit better. Right here is our little puck that we have to specify where the center of our light sweep is. So I'm going to turn off that solo switch, and that's starting to look pretty good. Maybe I want to take this guy and just move him a little bit further down. Notice I just selected him and I just was able to grab him. If by chance you grab the wrong thing, like maybe you didn't want to grab this, you wanted to grab the background, you can either select your layer or lock some of these other layers. So if I, for whatever reason, want to move the background, I can do that as well. In the next lesson, what we're going to do is animate all these pieces using keyframes. So we're going to animate this light sweep across here. We're going to animate this text layer coming in and animating the different text layers and give a little bit of animation to this piece here as well. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda with AV Ultra, and this has been After Effects Professional Training Lesson 1, Getting Started.